Hello all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'll be talking about what are the different steps involved before any implementation project starts. So the first important step before we start with our implementation project is to choose the right system integrator, or we call them as an implementation partner or a vendor. So there are different steps involved in choosing the right system integrator. The first important step is the client who is interested to implement Fusion or upgrade from, say, their existing EBS to Fusion, they need to prepare something called RFP, Request for Proposal document. And this particular Request for Proposal document would be sent to different vendors. This Request for Proposal contains a lot of information. It contains all the expectations, reporting, taxation, requirements of the client. So some of the It would be a very big document which contains all the requirements of the client. So some of the points which are mentioned in the RP could be, say, like the software should be accessible from any device and or from anywhere. The potential software should have capability to handle multiple currencies and multiple ledgers. The software should be in compliant with IFRS standard. The software should have good reporting capabilities, and so on. So this way, all the client's requirements are mentioned in the RFP document, and then the RFP document will be sent to the different vendors or different system integrators. And vendors might take a couple of weeks to fill this RFP, mention their comments against each of the requirement. They specify if the requirement can be met by standard all box functionality, or it can be customized, or if any workaround is available. So the vendors fill these RFPs and perform their presentation to the client. So I can just maybe give one personal experience or my personal experience for one of the client where I worked. A client prepared a big RFP document where we documented close to 1,000 line items of requirements for various financial and non-financial modules. So we documented all the requirements in a spreadsheet, and there were close to 1,000 line items. And that again, all those 1,000 line items is about different requirements. So we have sent this to five vendors, and we asked all these five vendors to perform their presentation. And out of five vendors, based on their responses, we have chosen three vendors, and we have sent our follow-up questions to these three vendors, asked them to present, their comments for our clarifications from these three vendors. And then at last, out of those three, we have finalized one vendor. So it's definitely not an overnight task or an easy task to choose the vendor. We spent hundreds of hours to finalize the vendor. We took into consideration various factors like the cost quoted by the vendor, their Oracle Fusion Cloud experience, the company's financial stability, customer references, and so on. So we took into consideration all these factors before finalizing the vendor. So the fourth important point is client will have several meetings with all these SIs or system integrators. And of course, you will also have a lot of internal meetings and then finalize the system integrator. Okay, before I get into my next slide, I just want to give some information about Oracle Fusion Environment Access. I got various requests from various subscribers asking me to provide details regarding any publicly available free Fusion environment. If you are working for a company which is an Oracle implementation partner or Oracle partner, or they are an Oracle partner network, then you might have a free demo environment from Oracle Corporation. But otherwise, if you are not part of that, then there is no free demo Fusion environment available in the market. Only option would be to go for a paid version. So even I was looking for a paid Fusion demo environment. Then I came across a contact, and this particular person is providing paid Fusion environment. This person looks reliable, and he's providing Oracle Fusion Cloud, EPM, and even Oracle EBS demo environments. I can just quickly share that information with you guys. And this is the business name of that particular person. This is the contact number. Anyways, I'll be specifying these details in the description section of this video. And note, I do not have any affiliations with this person. So I'll be mentioning this contact details, phone number, email ID, his Telegram link in the description. So if you are interested, you can directly get in touch with him. I do not have any affiliations. It's just that I got a lot of requests from different people. I thought of sharing this information. Okay, now let's get back into our slides. So after we choose a specific system integrator, there are these are the steps which are involved. So the first thing is would be SOW, which is a statement of work. This needs to be prepared and signed by both the, this will be generally prepared by the system integrator. This needs to be signed by both client and system integrator. So client needs to review the SOW internally. And in general, there will be again multiple revisions of this SOW based on the comments provided by the client. SI revises the SOW, and at last, final SOW will be presented by the client. Sorry, by system integrator to the client, and then client's stakeholder will be signing the SOW. And the next step would be a system integrator needs to gather required functional, technical, DBA, or maybe project manager resources. Of course, in a fusion project, DBA might not be required because the database is maintained by a European corporation. But yeah, at least you need to gather required functional, technical, and project manager resources. And initial kickoff meeting happens where steering committee members are announced. So steering committee are the critical members of the project who signs off the different milestones. Only once they sign off the milestone, the system integrator would be paid for the particular milestone, and we can also officially move to the next phase. So it is the responsibility of the project manager to provide regular updates about the project progress to this steering committee. And steering committee, as I mentioned, needs to sign up the major milestones. Only after they sign up the major milestones, we can proceed to the next phase. And of course, the last step would be system integrator needs to send certain resources to the client side, and certain resources will be working remotely. So these are the critical steps after we choose the system integrator. And in my next video, I'll be talking about what are the steps which are involved after implementation project starts. Okay. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video. For interesting videos on Oracle Financials, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.